Hey everyone and welcome back to The Breakdown. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to make a modded Minecraft server using Forge in 1.18. Forge is the most popular mod loader out there, and this video is going to be a step-by-step guide on creating a server on that. That means you'll be able to use awesome mods like Mr. Crayfish's Furniture mod or, you know, something like Biomes of Plenty in Minecraft 1.18 on your server. Using this video, right? It's going to go through everything. Now, as far as adding mods to your server, full disclosure, we have a separate video on that. As you can tell, this video is super, super long as it is, so we wanted to separate that. That way it could get the attention it deserves in a separate video. Also want to mention that this is not a 24-hour server. It's only up and running when your computer's up and running. On top of that, you're going to have a pretty good computer to be able to run this server. It wouldn't surprise me if in this video you see some lag because Forge servers in 1.18 are very, very resource intensive. So because of that, you need a very good computer to be able to run Minecraft and run your server at the exact same time. On top of that, this is only meant for your friends and family because it is using your public IP address. And with your public IP, people can do things like figure out where you live down to your latitude and longitude coordinates, as well as do things like DDoS you, which is just annoying. So anyway, with all that being said, what if you want a 24-hour server? What if you don't have a good computer? Or what if you want a public server? Well, Apex Minecraft Hosting is here to help. That's the first link down below, thebreakdown.xyz/Apex to get your server up and running with Apex Minecraft Hosting in under 5 minutes. You don't have to worry about things like privacy because you can make your server public or private. It's meant to be either one, and it's very simple to do it either way. On top of that, you also don't have to worry about server hardware because it's on Apex's hardware. Apex Minecraft Hosting is taking care of all the hardware needs of your server, and you don't have to worry about any of that. Last but not least, it's just a lot easier to run a server with Apex Minecraft Hosting, whether it's a public one, whether it's a private one, it doesn't matter. It's a lot easier to run it with Apex because it can be set up in under 5 minutes. You literally just select Forge 1.18 from a drop-down box, and your server is set up. It's that simple. So, nonetheless, you can see this is a 20-plus minute video here, and it's very, very difficult to create a Forge server in comparison to a vanilla server. There's more steps, right? So, because of that, it's something I want to mention up front, and that's what makes Apex so great. So, again, you can check Apex, the first link down below, thebreakdown.xyz/Apex, to get your server up and running. Nonetheless, though, if you want to create a server locally and run it on your own computer, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that as a modded server. Every single step is going to be covered here, so let's go ahead and jump on into it. The first thing you need to do is go to the second link down below. That's actually going to take you to our tutorial for getting Forge basically for single player or to play on other servers. Guess what? The same installer is going to be used here, so once you're here, just go ahead and click on the green download Forge button. That's going to take you off to the official Forge website, where we want to make sure 1.18 is selected. As you can see on the left-hand side, you can click on 1.18 and click on 1.18 there. Then when you see MC 1.18 here, it's selected, so you can go into download latest and click on the installer. And then take us off to AdFocus, or put your hands in the air and wave them like you just don't care, because you don't want to click on anything on this page whatsoever. Don't click on a single thing on this page except for the red skip button in the top right. The only thing you want to click is the red skip button in the top right, and when you click on that, in the bottom left, Forge will begin downloading. As you can see in the title, it says Forge 1.18, so it is safe to keep it. Almost all Firefox, it will be in the center of your screen where you want to save it. Again, it will say Forge 1.18. Now we can go ahead and minimize our browser, and we need to find the Forge file we just downloaded. Luckily, it's in our downloads folder. To get there, you want to go ahead and click on the little Windows icon on the top left of my screen, probably in the bottom left of your screen, that little Windows icon. Type in downloads. You have this downloads file folder here, and in here you will find Forge. Wow, I have a few different installations of Forge here. Which one do we want with this one? Sorry about that. There we go. So there is Forge. Now, once you've got Forge on your desktop, I'm going to go ahead and create a new folder on your desktop, and this is where your Forge server is going to be housed. So right-click, create a new folder. You can name this whatever you want, but I'm going to name it play.breakdowncraft.com because that's an incredible 1.18 Minecraft server that we run ourselves. Survival, Skyblock, you'll love it. Come play with us. Nonetheless, once you've got this on your desktop, we can go ahead and right-click on Forge, click on Open With, click on Java, and click OK. Now, a lot of you, though, may have issues at this point where if you have Java, you click OK, it doesn't open, or you don't even have this correct-looking logo. Things look weird there. In either of those cases, it's the same solution. And that solution is this. Minecraft Forge and Minecraft 1.18 in general now requires Java 17 in order to run, right? So you need Java 17 in order to run Minecraft Forge and Minecraft mods, Minecraft servers, anything to do outside of default Minecraft requires a separate download of Java 17. And luckily, we have an in-depth guide on it here. Once you're here, just click on the yellow download button, click on Windows, and click on the one next to the installer here, right like so, and you're good to go. It's going to install at that point like any other program. You get the idea. But from there, you may also need to run the jar fix. If you do install Java 17, you're still having issues, your Java file still looks weird, you can go and run the jar fix, which you can find in the description down below as well. It's a simple three-step process that'll link all the jar files in your computer to Java. Now we can go ahead and minimize our browser, and finally, right-click on Forge, click on Open With, click on Java, and click OK. Then it's going to open up the Mod System Installer for Forge, where we want to actually install Client first. That's going to install Forge locally, and once you've clicked on Install Client, click OK, and it's going to install Forge. Why would we do that? Because you need Forge installed locally in order to join your server. So anyone who joins your server needs Forge installed locally, and just a hint, they also need all the mods that are on your server installed locally as well. But we'll talk more about that in our mod video. But at this point, you should now have Forge successfully installed. As you can see, click OK, close out of that. Now we want to reopen up that Forge installer by right-clicking, clicking Open With. Same process, you know how to get there at this point. Once we're though in Forge Mod System Installer, we want to this time click on Install Server. A big red box will appear, and we want to click on these three dots on the right-hand side here. That's then going to open up the roaming folder, where we then want to click on Desktop on the left-hand side and find the folder we created. In my case, that's going to be play.breakdowncraft.com. Then go ahead and click on Open, and that red box will disappear. Click OK, and that's going to go ahead and install everything it needs for a Minecraft server into this folder that we created on our desktop. Now again, yours may not be called BreakdownCraft, it may be called Forge or something like that, but whatever it is, it's on your desktop and it's installing those files into it. I also want to remind you at this point to please like and subscribe if this video is helping you out. Nevertheless, successfully downloaded Minecraft server and installed 1.18-Forge. Awesome. Click OK and it closes out of that, and this Forge installer you downloaded can actually be deleted. Now let's go ahead and open up the Forge profile, or the Forge server folder on our desktop here, and then in here we kind of have everything we need to run the server right away, which is what I love about Forge. So once you're in here, you just double click on this run.bat file, and as long as you have Java set up and everything like it should be, right, it should just work. If you do have issues at this point though, it's because you need that Java we talked about earlier. Go to the description to grab it. Now, one issue you will have is it will say you need to agree to the ula.txt to run the server, and basically it should pause or stop the server at that point. When it does, press any key to continue, and you should have a few folders and files in here, one of which being the eula.txt. Go ahead and double click on the eula.txt to open up the Notepad file here, and in Notepad what you want to do is change eula equals false to eula equals true, exactly like that, assuming you agree to the Minecraft eula here, which we do. Now let's go ahead and do file save. There we go. Close out of that, and now the EULA is agreed to. We can double click on the run.bat file again, and this time Forge is going to start. Our Forge server is going to fire right on up without any issues. Just basically sit back and wait. By the way, don't be alarmed if there's any errors or anything like that in the process of starting Forge. That's just normal on a Forge server, especially on your first startup. So yeah, we're just sitting back waiting. It's going to take a few seconds, if not a few minutes, to get your Forge server up and running, depending on your computer. I also did just notice there was a little lag right there, and that is something that I want to mention. I have an amazing computer. It shouldn't be lagging, but Forge is just that laggy. Nonetheless, once you do have the Windows Security, if you do have this pop up, Windows Security Alert, that's a good thing, and you want to make sure that public and private networks are both checked, that both of these boxes are checked. Then click Allow Access. If you have issues later on with your friends being able to join, that is most likely the issue, and we do have a link in the description down below to how to fix Windows Defender if your friends can't join later on. Nonetheless, we do have basically two consoles up here. One is the old school style console that I prefer, and one's the more new GUI style console. Both are going to work exactly the same, so just use whichever one you find more preference in. Now, at this point, you can join your server, and I would actually recommend doing that. So I'm going to go ahead and open up Minecraft, and I'm going to join this server really fast. So let me open up Minecraft 1.18. Just make sure you're opening up Minecraft with Forge. So from the Minecraft launcher, you want to make sure you're using that Forge profile to launch up into Minecraft. So here we are in Minecraft. We have this Forge profile. That's the one that we want to use. I need to change the resolution so we can see better once we get in game, but this is the one we want to use. Just make sure you click and play on that one, and you're going to be good to go. So I'll meet you on the Minecraft main menu to join this server. All right, so here we are. Minecraft is open on the right. On the left, our Minecraft server is open. And as you can see, I did do a test join there because you always test it before you do it on the video. Nonetheless, let's go ahead and click on multiplayer here. And then you want to click on direct connection right here. Then we want to type in localhost. Yes, that's how you're going to join your server. And you're always going to join your server by typing in localhost as the server address. However, your friends are going to join via your public IP, but don't worry too much about that right now. now. We're going to talk more about it later in the video. Just know you'll always join via localhost. We can then click join server, and as you can see on the left-hand side, it's logging us right on in. Boom, looking good. So here we are in-game on our forward server. Got to remember this area because it will be coming back. That way you know this is the same server. We're not playing any trickery. It's the exact same server. We've got the sand here, all of that stuff. Looking good. So nonetheless, actually, here's what we'll do. We'll break one sand block, put it in our inventory, and now you'll know. Anyway, we can then go ahead and close out of the server. We just wanted to do a test run, a dry run, if you will, to make sure you can join your server. Now we can quit the game and stop our server because we're going to allow our friends to join this. To stop your server, by the way, always type in the console here, STOP, stop. Always type stop in the console and hit enter to stop your server the way it's supposed to be stopped and make sure everything closes out correctly. At this point, though, we then need to click the little Windows icon. The little Windows icon on the top left of my screen, probably the bottom left of your screen. And then you want to type in CMD, right? CMD, right like so. And we will have Command Prompt. Open up Command Prompt. And in Command Prompt, we want to type IPCONFIG. IPconfig, exactly like that, and hit Enter. We then have a bunch of numbers here, but there's two that we kind of want to pull out into a Notepad document. So, whoa, that's from another video. Let's go ahead and open up Notepad here. And in Notepad, we want to go ahead and pull out our IPv4 address and our default gateway. So IPv4 and default gateway. Gateway. There we go. I was able to spell eventually. And you can find these numbers on the left-hand side. So our IPv4 address is 192.168.1.67. Yours is completely different, most likely, and that's why we opened up Command Prompt and entered in IPconfig, because yours is different, and so we want to make sure that we get that. Nevertheless, a default gateway is also most likely different for you, but for me, it is 192.168.1.1. Now, if you do have a long string of numbers and letters, and then under that, there's a basically just numbers, you want to get the one that's just numbers. Some default gateways have what's called IPv6 and IPv4. We want the IPv4 default gateway. That's just technical jargon, though. Really, you just want the one that's just numbers, right? That's the one you want. Usually, it's on the second line if you have one with numbers and letters and one with just numbers. Anyway, we can now close out of Command Prompt. And here we are. We then want to open up our browser. And in our browser, we want to open up a brand new tab. And in this brand new tab, we want to type in our default gateway right up here at the top where you would normally type in, I don't know, youtube.com/thecrisisyt, which is actually the YouTube URL for this channel. A lot of people don't know that. Anyway, when you go ahead and hit enter here with our default gateway, it will pull up some sort of login box. Now, for me, it just pops in from the top, as you can see. For you, it might be in a pretty GUI on your screen. It might be in the center of your screen. Might pop in from the bottom of your screen. But there will be some sort of GUI or some sort of login box here. Now, in this login box, it's going to be completely different from what it is for me. And that's okay, because we have an in-depth guide if you don't know your router's username and password on how to find it. This is how to find your router's password. It's in the description, and it goes over 5 methods that you can start with method 1 and go to method 5 to find your router's password and get it set up and installed. Most people find it by method 4, by the way, so you won't have to call your ISP. Nonetheless, we can now go ahead and log right on into our router, and once we log in, it's going to look completely different for you than it does for me. And that is also perfectly okay, because we have an in-depth guide, of course, in the description on how to port forward on a ton of different routers out there, from Netgear and Linksys to, you know, like Orbi router to all the different ones out there. It's basically every router out there is in this, and if your specific router isn't listed in this video, that's okay, because a lot of routers are very, very similar. So I would encourage you to watch it anyway, go through it and watch kind of all the different ways you can port forward on different routers, because then when you get into your router, you might be like, well, it's not in this video, but it's kind of like a Verizon router, or it's kind of like a Netgear router, or it's kind of like a Linksys router. So go through this video. I promise it's going to help you. And then once you come to your router, things will look a lot more familiar, even if your specific router isn't listed. Nonetheless, though, we can now come back to our router and get port forwarding. For you, it's probably in the Advanced or Admin tab or Security tab. For me, it is in the Advanced tab. Then it is in the, like, Advanced Again tab. And then finally, it is in Port Forwarding / Port Triggering. That's where we're looking for, is either Port Forwarding, Port Triggering, or Apps and Gaming, NAT Gaming, or NAT Forwarding. So NAT Gaming, NAT Forwarding, Apps and Gaming, or Port Forwarding, also sometimes called Single Port Forwarding. As far as the sections this could be in Security, this could be in Firewall, this could be in Advanced Administration, or like it is for me, in Advanced and then Advanced again. Nevertheless, we can now go ahead and add this port forward in. For me, that means adding a custom service. However, I do have an old port forward I need to delete real fast because Well, yeah, we do these tutorials all the time. Anyway, we want to go ahead and make sure port forwarding is selected on your router, and then we want to go ahead and add a new port forwarder, add a custom service, or add a service, whatever it's called. You may just have a big long list on your port forwarding section of, you know, basically empty boxes. That's fine. Just start with the top one. Nevertheless, though, for your service name or ID, you want to go ahead and enter in Minecraft. For your protocol, that's going to be TCP/UDP, UDP/TCP, or both. Either way, make sure both are selected, and if for whatever reason you can't select both, do it once for TCP and once for UDP. Then we want to go ahead and move on to the external port. This could also be internal port, port 1, port 2, outside port, inside port. Doesn't matter what it says. If it says the word port at all, it's going to be 25565. So we external port 25565. For internal port or second port or anything involving the word port, it's also going to be 25565. So if you haven't entered in that number twice, it's perfectly okay and probably correct. Then we want to move on to the internal IP address here. Now, this also may just be called IP or be called your IPv4 address. Why is that? Because it is your IPv4 address. So in my case, that's 192.168.1.67, and you're going to enter in whatever yours is there as well. However, you may need to scroll down through a list of devices and find your device, select it in the list, and then you'll be good to go. However, for me, I have to enter it manually. Now we can go ahead and click apply, and we're good to go. Now for some of you, you will still need an external or outside port as well for your port forward. But that's okay, because everyone watching this video needs that, because that is the external IP address we were talking about earlier in this video that your friends will use to join your server. So go to the description down below and click on what's my IP address. And that will take you to our website here where you can see your public IP address. Then just go ahead and copy it. By the way, you can also see what people can get with your public IP address, country, region, city, latitude, and longitude coordinates. And that is why it is important that you don't give this server IP address out to anybody and everybody, only people you'd invite to your house. Nevertheless, you want to go ahead and copy this here, and if you did need it for your port forward, go in here, paste it in. Otherwise, go ahead and minimize your browser. We then want to go ahead and start our server right on up with the run.bat file here. Then we want to also go ahead and open up Minecraft, again, making sure that we are playing the Forge version of Minecraft. You, your friends, and anyone else who joins your server needs to have Forge installed and all the same mods that are installed on your server installed on their local Minecraft in order to join. Kind of complicated, I know, and that's why we have a dedicated video on adding mods, which you can check out after this one. We're basically done, though, so if you want to go check that out, you can. Most likely, as long as your friends can join via your public IP, you're good to go. But nonetheless, I'm going to go ahead and click this green play button, open up Minecraft with Forge, and I'll meet you when I'm on the main menu. All right, so here we are. Our Forge server is open, as well as Minecraft with Forge running in 1.18. We then want to come in here. We can direct connect, and I'm going to connect to the public IP. Again, you can only see those last three letters, 103, and that's just because you don't want to give this out to anybody and everybody. However, I do want to mention here that you might not be able to join via your public IP address. That's okay, as long as your friends can join. If after this your friends do have issues, it's going to be Windows Defender or an issue with your port forward. You can check out our Windows Defender guide in the description down below. And if it's an issue with your port forward, go ahead and look at the, you know, process we did with that and see if you can catch anything. It could be a firewall on your router as well. Now let's just go ahead and click join server, and I know it's going to join us right on in. Now, it may take it a second because it is a modded server, and modded servers typically take longer than vanilla servers, but there you go. Now, one thing I will mention is on the left-hand side, this is going to be blacked out or blurred out as well, or whited out or whatever, because that's my public IP right there, right? So that shows in the console as well. So just keep that in mind, and that's why we have that whited out. But nevertheless, here we are, same exact place, just a different time of day. And as you can see here, we do have our little block is missing. We'll put it back in its rightful place. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Your Forge server is now up and running. However, you can go ahead and get mods installed on it by going to the description down below and clicking on the How to Add Mods to Your Server link, and that'll take you to our in-depth video on adding mods to your server. Goes over everything and talks more about how you do have to have your friends, your friends have to have it installed. It goes over how to do all that. It's all in depth and shows you everything. So anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel for more incredible content every single day of the week. My name is Nick. This has been The Breakdown, and I'm out. Peace.